So these are my disclosure. So we have seen that for early closure, we know that the image guidance is very mandatory for each step of the procedure. So we know the very important procedural steps, which is a very precise transseptal puncture, which should be located inferior and posterior. Then the placement of the delivery sheet into the left atrial appendage with a good coaxial orientation. And finally, the device deployment at the intended landing zone with a correct orientation and stability. And we have some tools for that. Of course, we have fluoroscopy, which allows us to adequately visualize the equipment, the catheter, so on. But on the other hand, we cannot visualize the soft tissue, and that's where we need the TE, because we need to adequately visualize the key anatomical structures, which are, of course, the intraatrial septum, the left atrial appendage, and the left upper pulmonary vein. So the basic definition of image fusion, which doesn't apply only to EchoNavigator, but it indicates that you take patient-specific imaging data from two different modalities, and you align them in both space and time, which is also called code registration. And the resultant fused image, or image overlay, will contain some or all of the data from both images. So how does it work for 3DT and X-ray? So the system is based on a fast and very robust automated image-based algorithm. So it was based on the algorithm is based on the prior registration of a 3D model of the TE probe into multiple X-ray projection. And that very precise algorithm allows to localize and track the TE probe. In other words, the system will use the knowledge of the three-dimensional position of the TE probe within the fluoroscopy image. And since we know that the 3D TE dataset has a known spatial relationship to the TE probe, once the algorithm has tracked and recognized the TE probe, the TE images and X-ray can be now co-registered and synchronized in real time, which is important. So the first case step when you will use this technology is to perform a correct registration of the TE probe. This is very easy to perform, so you have to take two orthogonal view, and the system will localize and track the TE probe, and that will appear as a green spot on the TE marker. So you need two orthogonal view of at least 60 degree difference. And then the system allows you to display up to three different echo views. You have the classical echo view, which is showing up on the echo machine, which is always available during the procedure. Then you have the C-arm gantry view, which is a very important view, which is oriented in the same anatomic alignment as the C-arm gantry, and that's this view which will be fused with the X-ray. And this view will be automatically updated by each movement of the C-arm gantry. You have also a free view that can be rotated and cropped and manipulated by the operator at the level of the table using a sterile mouse pad. And on top of that, you have a marker feature allowing you to set a marker in anatomical point of interest, which can be interesting, for example, for paravalvular leak closure. So let me show you some example. Here you have a 3D projection of the septum on the fluoro screen, and we can very nicely see where are the different parts of the ostium, the inferior part, the superior, posterior, etc. So that allows you for a very precise localization on the fluoroscopic image of the septum. You see here an example of how we can very adequately visualize the septum during transseptal puncture. And you see here on the left of the screen on the 3D image that you are really nicely located in the inferior part of the fossa ovalis and also in the posterior part of the septum. And also we see that the needle is crossing the septum without asking to the sonographer if it's the case or not. It's a view that I like very much. When you have crossed the septum, you see that the transseptal sheet is really close to the appendage, that we have done a good transseptal puncture, that we have a very easy access to the appendage. So from the 3D data set, you can go back to 2D, so you can really manipulate the system in the way you want. This is another example, when you see that we are looking at putting the pigtail inside the appendage, and now we don't have to ask to the sonographer where we are, we see it directly, we only look at the fluoroscopy screen, which is, I think, make you gain some time during the procedure. You see here just the same case, where we go in the left upper pulmonary vein, and then by correct orientation, we see exactly where is the appendage, now we can orient it correctly, the pigtail, to go inside the appendage. So as I told you, the view that you have here on the fluoroscopy screen is the same view as if you inject the appendage in the same orientation. So here you have an area of 30 degree and 25 degree of caudal, and this is what you obtain when you inject the appendage, and this is exactly what you obtain when you fuse the echo image on the X-ray. So you see nicely the position of the delivery catheter here, which is close to the appendage. It's going towards the mitral valve. So again, in a very secure fashion, when you have loaded the device, you can enter the appendage. And you see here the difference. On the echo, it's very difficult to see the tip of the catheter. But on the X-ray fusion, you see exactly where you are going. So maybe you can be less traumatic by using this technology. Here you see the classical step when you have to deploy an amulet device. So the delivery sheet is placed in the left upper pulmonary vein, and then we move, and it jumped out from the left upper pulmonary vein, and we go into the appendage. And we can really visualize every step by looking only at the fluoroscopy screen. You see here we open the ball. Of course, we have access to the echo during all the procedure. But you see we enter, and then we do the counterclockwise rotation. And then we deploy the lobe of the device. And you see even the circumflex on the fluoroscopy screen, so we know that we are deep enough within the appendage. And here you see that the disc has been released. And we see on both images that we are deep enough and that the position is quite acceptable in this specific case. So this doesn't work always so simply, so you need some slight adaptation. For example, here where the X-ray view was set in an error 35 degree and some cranial angulation, which was the optimal view based on pre-procedural CT, because we thought that it was the view that was the most perpendicular to the plane of the LA ostium. But you see that the echo view now is at 133 degree, and this, in this case, shows a limited ultrasound slice in the overlay. So what you have to do is to ask the sonographer to adapt slightly the ultrasound angle and position to get the maximal overview of the left atrial appendage. And this has to be done when the sonographer has to look at the fused image. So you need to have a screen also for the sonographer that he can adapt the image according to the fluoroscopy. That can also improve the interaction between the operator and the sonographer, since the sonographer can watch all the steps of the procedure on the fluoroscopy screen, which is just in front of him. And you see, just by adapting the echo angulation, now we get a slightly better image, and we can see exactly the ostium, and we can carry on with the procedure. So very importantly, the sonographer, on top of what you see on the echo, has to look also at the fused image to guide correctly the operator. You see also for a Watchman device, this is a very interesting technology, because when you know that you have inserted the catheter within the appendage and you have loaded the device, you cannot inject anymore. So you have memorized where is the ostium approximately, but you cannot move anymore the catheter, or you don't see exactly where is the plane of the ostium, or you can draw a line on the screen, but this is not very accurate. And you see here that you have to put a 27 millimeter Watchman device. And using this technology, we can very accurately place the marker of the 27 millimeter Watchman device within the plane of the ostium. And you see the final result here that we can also check with this technology. So there are, anyway, very few data, clinical data with this technology. I could find only one very small randomized trial from the team of Düsseldorf, when they randomized 34 patients in a one-to-one fashion to receive LA closure guided by echo-navigator or without echo-navigator. And what they basically show is that you have, by using this technology, a significant reduction in radiation dose and fluoroscopy time, and without difference in procedural success or complication. And the amount of contrast media and procedural time was the same between both groups. So this is already my conclusion. So real-time fusion of echo and X-ray, I think it's a new tool that can be incorporated into procedural workflow of LA closure. There are, of course, potential advantages, which is, I think, an increase in the efficiency of the procedure and a decrease in radiation exposure and contrast injection and procedural time once you have crossed a certain learning curve. However, we need further large-scale trials to assess the real safety and clinical impact during LA closure.